In this video, we're going to look at some templates in Miro. Okay, so jumping back into our dashboard, I'm going to double click on our test document. And I'm going to go onto the menu on the left and I'm going to click onto templates. So it loads up the templates modal and it's got some recommendations for me. So we've got a search up here. We've also got a tick box here. So when we're creating a new board, this will always pop up. So you can turn that on or off. So let's see what recommendations I've got. So I've got a mind map here, a flow chart, a product roadmap. I've got some workflows, a visual table, brain writing, monthly planner. There's a Kanban framework here. So let's click on mind map so we can either use it or click on preview. I'm gonna click on preview first. We can go back to the templates here. We can copy the link to share it. Got some information here and some related examples. So we can use a blank template or we can use it pre-filled. So I'm going to click use pre-filled. Okay, so that's loaded into the board. And as you can see, the template loads and you can edit any of the text that you need. And you can adjust this. Let's see if we can add something here. Yeah, so we can continue the mind map and add things coming off the different branches here. So that's really useful. So I'm going to delete that just to clear the space. Go back into templates. Let's see what else we have. Okay, so let's have a look at some use cases. So meetings and workshops. Okay, let's have a look at the first one, OKR planning. Let's click on preview. So it gives us a little bit about the template here. And I'm going to use a pre-filled template. So let's click on that. Close that feedback down. Just give it a second to load in. If I zoom in slightly, so OKR planning, it gives us some extra information here on how to use the template. Looks like there's a video as well that we can watch. We can customize this to our team. And it looks like we've got step-by-step information on how to populate each section of this template. So we've got a goal section, got some supporting content here. We can add some statistics when we're having the meeting. So you can add some useful quotes in there. Let's scroll up. So we've got question and answers. So this is something you'll do as a team. And there's some brainstorming. And again, we've got some in-depth instructions here and links to videos. So how to create them gives you some information in a video up here. So there's a section here as well for defining your next steps. So quite an in-depth template. It's free. So you could move things around and customize the template as you need. Maybe you don't need the next steps. You can just get rid of that. And then you can keep the other sections of the template. So again, pretty good considering it's free. So let's delete that. Go back into templates. Let's have a look at brainstorming. Let's scroll down. So there is a persona map. Let's just click use, jump straight into it, see what we have. So we can add some information in here on research, what we know about our users. So I'm guessing we can take out different post-its and document things there. And then there's a little template here that we can populate regarding our persona. So that's pretty good, quite simple, three steps. So let's go back into templates again. So agile workflows, got some templates in here, mapping and diagramming. So we've got some flow charts, customer journey map. Let's preview this one. You can also zoom in. Actually, let's make this bigger. So you can zoom in and preview the template before you use it. So you've got the journey steps, what people were feeling, what they thought. And then we've got some ownership here. And we've got some emojis down here that you can use as part of the template. I'm going to press escape to come out of full screen. I'm going to go back to the templates. Let's go to research and design. You can see that there is a Jake Knapp design sprint template. Let's go in here and preview that. And let's just click on use the template. Right, so let's zoom in. So this is the design sprint by Jake Knapp. So you've got the design sprint spread out over 5 days. So you've got the first day there. You've got the second day to do with recruiting and sketching, the third day deciding on things, the fourth day prototyping, and the fifth day testing. So a really good template that you can use, and that's based off the Jake Knapp design sprint. So it's quite a good one. So let's click back into templates again. Let's have a look at strategy and planning. We've got one to do with workflow, timelines, stakeholder map. So let's have a look at this organizational chart. Let's click on preview. Let's make that a bit bigger. Let's use a blank template and let it populate. And now if we zoom in, great. So there's a blank template that you could use for your company. So you could add the different departments and different levels within your company using this template. So very straightforward to use. Just go back to templates again. Let's have a look under this section. So community templates. So we've got stuff from AJ and Smart. Let's have a preview of that. So it's the Lightning Decision Jam. Let's make that big screen. Let's have a look. So AJ and Smart specialize in workshopping. So it might be worth having a quick look at their templates if you're considering doing workshops. Let's go back and go to icebreakers. This looks like it's new. Something to do maybe before you're starting a meeting, or when you want to get people ready for a workshop. You've got some warm-ups, you've got some icebreakers, and there's a section here of shared templates, but I think we have to upgrade to use this section. So I'd encourage you to log in, play around with the templates, and see what works for you. So thanks for getting to the end of this short video series. Like and subscribe, leave some comments below, and I will see you in the next video.